Ancient Dragon is an optional boss that has Dark Souls 2. Oops. Knew it sounded familiar. And I'm gonna try and not... Well, I can ask you, because we're gonna be playing the game anyways. The Ancient Dragon is the one where, like, you need to, like, run up, like, a tower and, like... hit it with a gate or shoot an arrow at it or something. I kind of remember that fight because it was unique for Dark Souls to me. Oh, it steals humanity. Oh. Yep, and of course I got hurt because it wouldn't just get out of my way. Oh my gosh. No, dude, I was caught on your wing. What is the deal? Nice. All right, I'm just gonna ignore all the items and stuff. I'm pretty sure I don't need them, so. Oh my gosh, it's a sludge monster. Get out. Oh, the stairs or something. Oh, what's this? Oh, I'm dead, aren't I? Oh, is this where I just need to, like, jump into the abyss? But I'm not even wearing the ring. I'm waiting for them to leave me alone. All right, cool. I think we're cool. So what? I need to take this off? And put on Covenant of Artorias. Oh my gosh. Ready? It's at the top of the tower, yeah. Yep. Do I get hurt? No, I don't. All right, here we go. Oh, man. Oh, there they are. Or one of them, I guess. Oh my gosh. What is this? No, no, let go. Oh my gosh, seriously, this is gonna be one of those fights? Alright, this is gonna be one of those fights, huh? Definitely. Oh no, really that fast? Oh my gosh, what? No! Dude, I didn't even know you were there! Oh my gosh, really? Is this my life? Is this my life right now? Are you kidding? Are you kidding? Dude, you don't even have that much health left. That's the, like, probably the thing that's most sad about this. Oh my gosh. You like to make out with you? Do I need to tell your wife? Probably not. It's video games, doesn't count. Ow. Alright, hold on. Alright, stop it. Oh my gosh, dude. We should have had this. I did not think that they were gonna try and make out with me. It's I don't know. I know I'm hard to resist, but they took it to a whole nother level. Let me tell you. Whole nother level. More poise will make this fight so much easier. Yeah. I think we could have had it there, if I actually played smarter. But I honestly didn't know what to expect. Like, I didn't remember that all that stuff happens. And also, this run is kind of doo-doo. Oh my gosh, you know what too? Shadow, now that I've gone into the abyss, now that I've gone to the abyss before, do I still need to wear the Artorias' ring? Because that's gonna affect things big time. I didn't have as much stamina. I have to wear it the whole. Oh gosh. I could always try and change out of it as soon as I get in there. I just don't know if I'm going to be able to do it that quickly. Actually, no, I'm not going to be able to do it that quickly. I can guarantee it. Oh man, it's one of those ghosts. You see that? Scared. Oh, you think you die if you take it off while you're down there? Okay. Well then, I guess we're not doing that. This is why you just never jump into the abyss. That's true. Also, something I did wrong at first. Oh, right there. Was that... Wow. Dude, listen to that music. It's so good. Where's the third one? There it is. Ow. Dude, I even tried blocking that. Ow. Oh no! And the last one is over here. Achievement unlocked. Defeat the four kings. Bequeath Lord Soul Shard. Nice. Dude, there's four of them too. That's weird. Yeah, they didn't get close enough. Skill shock. Oh my gosh. Well, there we go. Oh my gosh, 50,000 to level up. That's ridiculous. Go. I would check in and see this first thing. Oh my gosh. Oh, this is the Sunlight Altar? Oh, I didn't know that. I guess I have to go from here. Yep. I guess this stream might be shorter than I thought it was going to be. Which is good that it's a bonus stream. And also it's a Thursday night. I've been streaming a lot, so it's actually is kind of perfect. Pulled it for myself a little while ago and saw the DS1 and DS2 final boss. All right, cool. We shouldn't really have a problem. We might have to... If I had to guess, we might have to try it like 2 or 3 times, but it's really not a hard fight.
No, I'm fine. Well and wide awake. Do not treat me like an old...
I don't know about y'all, but I'm actually feeling a little sad that we're gonna be done. And then it's Dark Souls 2.
I am pleased to see you well. Is it something urgent?
Warp, please.
Very well. Then stay still.
And the sad thing is, I don't even have Dark Souls 2 downloaded yet, so it's not even like we could jump into it. Dude, I am the tastiest undead person ever. Obviously. The run there is harder than Gwyn himself, depending on if you cheese it or not. I don't know what you mean by cheesing, but I remember that all I do is run. Oh, cheese, Gwyn. Oh, no. Dude, look at that mask. Creepy. Oh, it automatically gives you 20 Estus flasks. Oh my goodness. Infinite poise. Yeah. I don't have that. Yeah. Oh. You're not gonna attack me, are you? Nope. I don't think so. That's why you're see-through. This place looks amazing too. Kiln of the First Flame. And all this is supposed to be ash, right? Pretty neat. Oh my gosh. Also, I gotta switch back into the Havel ring. So, if I remember correctly, it took us, what, 2 tries at Four Kings? It was 2 tries at Four Kings. Manus took us, what, 6 or 7? Which is unbelievably much, like, an incredibly amount better than it was our first run. It's really Bed of Chaos. Bed of Chaos really messed up things for us. Ah, crap. Gonna go to the right. Ooh, Black Knight stuff? What? Oh, the boss room is up there. I think, right? Or is that the way we came in? Is that the way we came in? That's the way we came in, isn't it? Yep. Oh my gosh, and look at these two. They're like, what is this guy doing? Does he want to finish this game or what? I do, but I just don't remember what way I'm supposed to go. Ah, right here. Found it. Not going to the left. I think we just go down here to the right. Yeah, definitely lost at that part there. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, man, dude. What? Listen to this music, too. Ow. That hurt. Nope. Ow. Okay, stop it. Nope. Stop it. Stop it. Oh, my gosh. Ow, I don't want to get grabbed. I don't think he wants to make out with me, though. So, I think we're good there. All right, dude. You are so aggressive right now. All right. Oh. Oh, what? Okay, I was I don't know. I don't even know if this is possible, but I was about to try and oh no. I was about to try and backstab him. Oh my gosh, dude, you are so aggressive right now. What? Oh my gosh, stop it! Stop! Oh no. No! Dude, let a man drink in peace! Oh no. Ah, dead. Whoa! Dude, this guy is so mad that I want to take his job! Nope. Oh my gosh, dude! He was so aggressive! Yeah, the damage was good, but man, he just would not let me drink. He needs a Snickers, definitely. Gwyn is tough if you don't cheese because he's triggered at Dekua every time you heal. Oh! Is that like built into the game? Like, oh, you healed, you idiot. That's okay. I'm pretty sure this took us two or three times the first time we played. And, I think we tried the parry way once. And I didn't do well with it. So. You healed? I'm gonna punish. Yeah, exactly. Oh, you healed? Oh, you drank from the Estus? Wow, you idiot. Yeah. We're fine, though. We're fine. We got plenty of time. I'm actually kind of glad we're gonna finish this early. So I can continue editing videos after this. Oh, what? You weren't there last time. Oh my gosh. Alright, in all seriousness, I would probably be under 100 deaths if it wasn't for gravity. Oh my gosh, it's your fault, Shadow. You jinxed me. You realize that, right? Infinite poise is if you wear all of Havel's armor. Basically, you can't get stunned. And your defense is so high that it's hard for the enemy to really do much damage. You can just stand there, and while he attacks you, you can attack right back. Oof. I'm gonna drink now. Hopefully they aren't following me. Oh, they're right there. Come on. Oh, I gotcha. I gotcha. Yeah. But it's at the cost of, like, being able to roll. So basically, you become a tank, like, big time. Just if your mobility gets nerfed, but it's okay, because you should just be able to take all the hits in the world. Wait, don't understand. I am the chosen one. Oh, no. Yes, Anakin. Oh. Got greedy. I did. You're right. I did. That's exactly what it was. I just wanted to stand right in his face and just tank him. Or like do as much, what do they call him? Oh, burn him. I wanted to burn him. Kind of like the same way that he was trying to do to me. I wanted to kind of try and burn him down and then heal and then go back into it. If he would actually let me heal. Probably mention that. Oh. You darn poker. Dude, look at how much damage he did. That was one swipe from a Black Knight. It can be a really quick fight. It can be. Gimmick fights? I feel like they're not necessarily gimmick fights, but they're kind of, it's almost like they're there to teach you a mechanic. It's almost like, oh, hey, this thing that you should probably know, You know, at this point, they're like, use the parry. It's really going to help you. And it's like, yeah, but I suck at parrying. Is he... he is the keeper of the fire, of the bonfire in here. Basically, like, what, the keeper of the light? The shadow would know. What the heck was that, dude? I didn't even mean to do that. Yeah, Johnny Cash. You see my shirt? I love this shirt. And there we go. GG's. It's over. Gwyn, Lord of Cinder, Soul of Gwyn. Nice. See, and that's kind of the way that I beat him the first time too. Was just you got to be pretty aggressive. Yo, 70,000 souls. Nice. And here we go. He is the sun god king of the realm in order to keep the first flame that basically keeps everyone alive. He sacrificed himself to the flame. However, in doing so, put a curse on humanity, making it so every time a human dies, they lose more of their humanity until they become a mindless zombie. All right, here we go. Link the fire. Just like I said, basically to save the world, we need to set ourselves on fire forever. Same for the DS3 boss? I don't remember. I remember Dark Souls 3 being, like, gameplay-wise, the best one. But I don't remember a lot of the bosses, and I don't remember a lot of what I did. Shadow does know pretty much everything about Dark Souls. Achievement unlocked to link the fire. Nice. Oh my gosh, wait. Oh man. Oops, I meant to walk out. But okay. We're a good guy though. We saved everybody. There we go. 179 deaths. It's not so bad. Thank you for the GGs. Yeah, this was a pretty good run, and in all seriousness, yeah, I wonder if we might have been under 100 deaths if just gravity would have just left me the heck alone. you know. All right, we'll let these run, and then we'll wrap things up for the night. But thank you for hanging out for this. And if Bed of Chaos didn't exist, exactly. Like, well, like that's the thing. That was a bunch of deaths to gravity there. Just gravity itself pulling me down. Yeah, we did this a lot quicker than I thought. If we had pushed last night, I bet we could have done it. We ended stream at like 10:45. We could have gone until like midnight and beaten it. That's okay. Dark Souls 3 is the final lighting of the flame. You come back to Firelink Shrine and beat the soul. Get the soul of Cinder? A soul composed of every character that had lit the first flame in the lore. And yes, that includes both of your characters from 1 and 2 and Gwyn. Oh, cool. Yeah, I remember Dark Souls 3 that it just looks a lot prettier. Even Dark Souls 2 is kind of graphically a pretty good bump in graphics, because even with the remastered, some of this still looked kind of rough, but it worked because of what it is, I feel. But you know what? I wouldn't be surprised if this game eventually gets some sort of remake done to it or something. I don't know. Wouldn't be surprised, especially because, like, I'm sure From Software has the funds now, so...
So the courier who cheated death in the cemetery outside Good Springs cheated death once again, and the Mojave Wasteland was forever changed.
Never-ending cycle until DS3, yeah, basically. That's why the Soul of Cinder is able to use every weapon and every magic type.
And eventually we'll be getting to Demon Souls as well, speaking of remakes. That'll be happening. I'm gonna be holding out on Bloodborne until there's some kind of remaster or something that happens. Some sort of announcement or something, because I really want to play that game. I just know it has a lot of performance issues, and I feel like I'm so used to playing games in 60 FPS that I can play things at 30, but if it's an unstable 30, which that game is a lot of times, it's gonna really mess with me, and I'm probably just gonna quit and just be like, nah, we'll just wait. One short of 180 deaths. Yep, that bothers me. How about Oblivion? We're not playing that until like the winter time. Yeah. Next is gonna be Dark Souls 2. Is probably what we're gonna start tomorrow, unless if I need a night off from Dark Souls and we'll play something else. But more than likely, I'm just gonna jump right into it because Dark Souls 2 was very mean to me last time, and I'm looking forward to playing it, and I'm also not looking forward to playing it. So in my mind, the quicker I get to it, the quicker I can get out of it, and I can go to Dark Souls 3 and then we can actually do that game proper. Play Bully? I played Bully on stream like 5 years ago or 6 years ago. Bully needs a remaster or a remake or something.
Yes, indeed.
Or a sequel.
The dark sign brands the undead.
Somersaulting all over the house. It's scaring the kids. Yes, I'm rolling out of the way of all the
and
monsters.
In this land, the undead are corralled and led to the north.
Yeah, Dark Souls 2 is going to look and feel different when we play it, for sure.
To await the end of the world.
I'm also going to have to keep in mind, the thing that I did not forget about Dark Souls 2 is that enemies don't infinitely respawn. So I'm going to have to remember that and be much more careful and think out what I'm doing, because I didn't know that at first, and we just kept on going and going, and I kept losing souls, and I just thought, oh, it's fine. I'll get them back eventually. And then it turns out, no, actually, those are lost forever. And those enemies only respawn for, what, 10 times? Yeah. I am not a bully. I think you're confused, Mario. I think you're confused as to what Knife is talking about. Look at the look on that face. What just happened here? I was here like 30 hours ago. Oh, look at those like maggots or cockroaches. What the heck? And there we go. Look at this face. Remember that face. If you can even see it, it's pretty dark in here. I killed the puppy, though. The puppy murderer. That is true. My character was. But yeah, everyone, this is actually where I'm going to wrap it up for the night. Like I said, this actually ended up being a lot quicker than I thought it was going to be. It's a bonus stream, so this works out perfectly. I'm going to start editing things down. Hopefully, eventually, in the next like week or so, I can start actually publishing the Dark Souls streams to YouTube. In case if you do want to relive all that again, for some odd reason. But yeah, those will be up eventually, I think we're gonna be back to regular streams, so Monday, Wednesdays, Fridays again. This week we just did a couple extras just to bang out this game, and we did, and it was great. I still love this game. I think it's really, really good. It's got flaws, but what game doesn't have flaws? But it's and keep in mind too, this game originally came out in what, 2011? It's either 2011 or 2012. It might be 2012. So it's nearing the decade mark. So it's definitely got some age on it, but man, it's still good. a lot of fun to play. It's a challenge. Feels good after you do something, which is always good, you know. Am I ever going to play Detroit Become Human?
I don't know.
Maybe when I'm like 60. Will you still watch me when I'm 60? Think? Yeah, dude. Thank you for the GG. Still one of my favorite games. Same. I really enjoy this one. Really good. 3 is better, though. I'm hoping I can finish it, but like I remember 3 feeling a lot better. 3, though, we kind of ran through it, too. We really didn't have a whole lot of trouble with 3. You thought I was 60? Okay, well, then will you still watch me when I'm 80? Never played Dark Souls. Well, there's no time like the present. I think Dark Souls, the Xbox 360 version, is on Game Pass, if you wanted to give it a shot. I thought I was 70. Okay, well, would you still watch me when I'm 90? I guess so. That doesn't sound convincing. What if I was to tell you, when I'm 90 years old, I'll play Detroit Become Human? What? I thought you were 40. You're closer. If you are still streaming at 90, I'll laugh. If I'm still alive at 90, I will be laughing with you. Yeah. All right, everyone, though, I'm going to go. Everyone, thanks so much for hanging out and all the good vibes. Hope you all enjoyed. I can't even fathom what number that is. It will be real life by then. Well, there we go. It'll be topical. All right, y'all. I'm going to take off. And, hopefully I'll see you tomorrow. Take care. Peace.